chapter 3. Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hello, you got to say amen.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 3, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. For you're dead, your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify, therefore, your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, in order to affection, evil, concupiscence, covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in which ye also walked sometime when ye lived in them. But now ye also put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie will not one to another, seeing you put off the old man with his deeds, put on the new man which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him, where there is neither Jew nor Greek, circumcision or uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. Put on therefore as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to preach just for a little while, and this may be more teaching than I think preaching. The true love of God. The true love of God. Amen. Let's just ask the Lord to help us tonight. My God, I give you glory. Lord, I recognize the fact that I am nobody and nothing in your sight. I need you like I need my next breath, God. Lord, I'm asking you that you would move into this house tonight. God, anoint the lips of clay. God, anoint the ears of the hearers. God, you said your word would not return void. Let it go forth and do the work you want it to do. Let it accomplish the things you want accomplished in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. You can be seated after you give him a hand clap. Jesus, thank you. My God, I love you, Lord. I worship you, God. I praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Now, I'm going to read that from the East Texas version. And I'm in West Texas, but that's all right. Amen. So, if you're serious about living this new resurrection life with Christ, act like it. Hallelujah. I love that. Pursue the things over which Christ presides. Don't shuffle along, eyes to the ground, absorb with the things right in front of you. Look up and be alert to what's going on around Christ. That's where the action is. See things from his perspective. Wow. Your old life is dead. Your new life, which is your real life, even though invisible to spectators, is with Christ in God. He is your life. Hallelujah. Everybody say, he's my life. When Christ, your real life, remember, shows up again on this earth, you'll show up too. The real you, the glorious you. Meanwhile, be content with obscurity like Christ. And that means killing off everything connected with that way of death. Sexual promiscuity, impurity, lust, doing whatever you feel like, whenever you feel like it, and grabbing whatever attracts your fancy. Hallelujah. That's a life shaped by things and feelings instead of by God. Uh-huh. It's because of this kind of thing that God is about to explode in anger. It wasn't long ago that you were doing all that stuff and not knowing any better. Uh-huh. But you know better now, so make sure it's all gone from good for good. Bad temper? Or irritability? Oh my. Meanness? Help us, Lord. Profanity, we don't got a problem with that. Dirty talk, better not have any of that. Don't lie to one another. Okay. You're done with that old lie. It's like a filthy set of ill-fitting clothes you stripped off and put on the fire. Hallelujah. You got them took care of. You stripped off the old stuff and you threw it in the fire. Now you're dressed in a new wardrobe. Every item of your new way of life is custom made by the Creator with His label on it. Hallelujah, I like that.
Praise the Lord.
All the old fashions are now obsolete.
Hallelujah.
Words like Jewish and non-Jewish, religious and irreligious, insider and outsider, uncivilized and uncouth, slave and free mean nothing. From now on, everyone is defined by Christ. Everyone is included in Christ. Amen. He's talking about those that have received the Holy Ghost. So chosen by God for this new life of love, dress in the wardrobe God picked out for you. Compassion, kindness, humility, a quiet strength, and discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place. You know we always are in that race for first place. Hallelujah. Quick to forgive an offense. Forgive as quickly and completely as the Master forgave you. And regardless of what else you put on, wear love. Hallelujah. It's your basic all-purpose garment. Never be without it. Let the peace of Christ keep you in tune with each other, in step with each other. None of this going off and doing your own thing. Hallelujah. And cultivate thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, the message, have the run of the house. Amen. Give it plenty of room in your lives. Instruct and direct one another using good common sense. Amen. There's a whole lack of that nowadays. And sing. Woo! Hallelujah. Sing your hearts out to God. Let every detail of your lives, words, action, whatever, be done in the name of the Master Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Thanking Him every step of the way. Hallelujah. Amen. How much more do you need? I shouldn't even have to preach that one. That preaches itself. Amen. The true love of God. I want to just talk to you just a little bit. And of course, I've preached from some of this before. Amen. We know all the things about all the ill-fitting things that He said in His word here. I like that when He said, you know, you're done with that old life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It's like a filthy set of ill-fitting clothes that you stripped off and put in the fire. Now you're dressed in a new wardrobe. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible said, we're a new creature in Christ Jesus. We're not the same old guy we were or the same old gal we were before the Holy Ghost came in. Hallelujah. You know, the biggest problem I have found in the apostolic church in all my years, I've had the Holy Ghost 45 years, so I've seen a lot of trouble, I've seen a lot of problems, but you know what? Every church has its trouble and its problems, amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. But one of the biggest things that I have seen in 45 years of living for God is folks that they do their best about living for God in some areas, but they skip out in other areas. Hallelujah. Okay. Oh, Lord, here we go. Here we go. Amen. We're not going to lie to each other, hopefully. Amen. If you do, well, you're going to be accounted for because, you know, the Lord said that all liars shall have their part where? In the lake of fire. Amen. So we got to be careful about lying to each other. He said it means killing off everything connected with that former way of death. Hallelujah. And then he begins to name all the stuff, you know, he talked about the promiscuity, the lust, doing whatever you feel like, whenever you feel like, grabbing whatever affects your fancy. That's a lie shaped by things and feelings instead of by God. Amen. We gave up that life, and every one of us here this evening can say, you know, that's behind me. Everybody that's been filled with the Holy Ghost, that's a past tense. Amen. I don't seek after those things in the world any longer. I'm through with that lifestyle. I'm through with those things. Amen. But there's other things that we still allow to rule and reign in our lives that he mentioned. sections in the scripture tonight, and I want to touch on a few of those because I want us to make it to heaven. Hallelujah. Amen. The bottom line is this pastor is trying to get you to heaven.
Amen.
Amen. And the second thing is I want to see a move of God here in such a powerful manner. And let me explain something to you. We can change the atmosphere of the Spirit of God. You know, I'm always preaching to you about coming into the church and worshiping because that sets an atmosphere. Amen. We got to set an atmosphere for the miraculous to happen, don't we?
Amen.
I said, we have to set an atmosphere for the miraculous to happen in. If it's going to happen, it's going to happen because we have created an atmosphere where it can work in. Hallelujah. Amen. I want this church to be a church of faith. I want this church to be a church that walks forward and don't look back. Amen. Let me just say this tonight. There's things that have happened in the past in some of your lives, amen, in this place. There's things that have happened in your past, amen, that you need to just leave them alone and leave them behind and walk on because they're gone now. Hallelujah. Amen. God has removed them. And if God has removed them, then you don't need to worry about them anymore. Hallelujah. But the devil likes to drag up old dogs. Amen. You know, I remember years ago, we used to have this old goofy dog at the house. And, you know, he liked to get out of the yard every now and then. And every once in a while, he'd get out of the yard, just Eliza, and he'd come back to the house, and he would stink to high heaven. And I'm like, what have you been into? Where have you been, you nasty dog? What have you been doing? And it didn't matter. You could clean him up. You could give him a good bath. And I was a teenager, and I would give him a bath, you know, and I like to keep a clean dog around. And before you know it, you'd turn your head, and he'd be gone. And in a little while, he'd appear back in the yard, and I'd walk up to pet him, and oh, my goodness, the smell would nearly knock me down. You know what he had been doing? He had been going down the highway, and he had found some dead stuff. Yeah. Hallelujah. And it may have been, it bound to have been dead for a month, because it sure smelled like it. Amen. I don't know how long it had been dead. I don't even know what it was. I didn't go see. All I know is he had found some dead stuff, and he had rolled in that mess. Amen. He had rubbed his nose all down in it. He had just took and laid down and rubbed himself all over. He had that stinking stuff all over him. It wasn't anything you could see. There was nothing really visible on him, but you could smell the smell. You know why? He wouldn't leave the dead stuff alone. Hallelujah. Amen. We need to learn that God has taken care of things. Amen. And the devil comes dragging that old stuff back up in your life. You say, that's already handled. I refuse to roll in the dead stuff of the past. I'm going forward in the Holy Ghost. Amen. There's things in my life I'm not proud of. There's things in my life back there that I did. Amen. That if I would have continued the way I was going, I would probably be in a grave by now. But God, in his mercy, saved me and brought me out. Hallelujah. And when he did, all that stuff behind me is still behind me. Hallelujah. Miss Lot, when she come out of the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, you know what the problem was? She couldn't leave that lifestyle. She was so used to the sinful nature of that city. Amen. The Lord said, I don't want you to turn around and look back at it. You just go forward, you face a new life. Hallelujah. Because I'm fixing to get rid of the old stuff. I'm fixing to burn it all to a crisp. But she just couldn't do it. There was something on the inside of her that kept attracting her back. And she kept looking around. And finally, she just turned and looked back. And the Bible says she instantaneously turned into a pillar of salt. I want you to understand, God may not make a pillar of salt out of you. Amen. But you can become hardened by the things out of your past.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. Amen. You can become hardened by the things that, well, you don't know what he did to me. You don't know what they how they treated us. It doesn't matter. Amen. Because now you're beyond that. Hallelujah. Amen. You need to get an understanding that God has taken care of that business. Amen. That's no longer something you got to deal with. Now you can go forward in the name of Jesus. Now, amen, you can progress. Now, amen, your church can grow. Now, amen, all those things that have held you back spiritually all this time, all these years, amen, you can drop it and walk away from it and go forward. Hallelujah. In the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Amen. So we're not looking back, we're looking forward. Amen. My old life is dead, it's gone.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, you know, things happen in our lives, and sometimes they're not good. Amen. Bad things happen to good people.
That's right.
Amen. I would be lying if I told you they didn't. They do. Bad things happen to good people. As long as there's a devil alive and well, they're going to happen. Amen. But we have to have an understanding that God, amen, has brought us out of that situation. Now, one of the biggest problems some of us has got is we have never forgiven folks who abused us in whatever way it was they abused you. Amen. I'm not talking about just particularly one type of abuse. There's more than one type of abuse. Amen. And you know who I'm talking to. Each of you knows who I'm talking to. Each of you, because I feel like tonight that I'm talking to more than one of us. Amen. There's things in your life that there was people that had things that they did in your life that were not pretty, and they took advantage of you. Amen. But I'm here to tell you tonight, you need to forgive them and go forward. Hallelujah. Because you understand, amen, God is about to carry you to another level in the spirit. And we don't want any hindrances. I don't want anything to hold you back from what God has got for you. Hallelujah. I don't want anything that's going to hinder you. But Brother Driscoll, you don't know what they said. I don't care what they said. It's all behind me. Hallelujah. Oh, but you don't understand. Yeah, I do understand. You know what? I've been talked about. I've been the guy that's received the bad stuff on the other end. Amen. But you know what I had to do? I had to forgive them and keep going. Hallelujah. It might not have been pretty. It might not have been something. It's something I may not even want to talk about to anybody. But I want you to understand. Amen. Whatever it was, whatever the situation was, amen, whoever it was, it's behind me. I'm headed towards home. Hallelujah. Oh, I've got my eyes on a prize much bigger than the things of this world, much bigger than the people that have been a hindrance to me in the past. I'm going to forgive. I'm going to forget. Hallelujah. Oh, there's a situation. There's a problem. We can't love like we should our brothers and sisters because of things that happened in the past. Hallelujah. All right. Amen. You got to move on. You got to move on. Amen. You know, one of the things we're doing here, you know, I don't know. Brother Josh, you didn't even know I was going to say all this, but one of the things we're doing here, I've asked Brother Conde to take this little situation and begin to organize things here in the church, and we're, you know what we're doing? We're just trying to get it where everybody can work with everybody. Hallelujah. Amen. You know what we're doing? We're trying to create unity in the church. Because let me tell you something. On the day of Pentecost, they were all in one mind and what? One accord. Hallelujah. They were all there for the same reason. There wasn't no schisms. There wasn't anybody talking about the other one. Oh, Lord. Because John started speaking in tongues before Peter did, they didn't say, oh, my God, God loves Peter. God loves John more than he does Peter because he spoke in tongues quarter. Hallelujah. You know, there was nothing there. There was unity in that place. Hallelujah. And because there was unity, yeah. Oh, Lord.
Come on.